in that time, I had actually had a buddy of mine, and we were sitting on the couch, and we were rolling up a joint, and he looked at me and he says, "Would you like to go to church today?" And I go, "Yeah." I never even hesitated. I put it back underneath the couch, and we went to a little Baptist church, and I gave my life to the Lord that day. Came home after that, and I dumped the pot down the toilet. Okay, and then I started going to a four-square Pentecostal church, and they had asked for anybody that would like to see the baptism of the Holy Spirit to come forward, and I did, and I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, but the problem was that I didn't have disciples. I didn't have proper discipleship. I was working in the oil field. I kind of fell back into the old school way of things. But there was an elder in that church, that four square church, that him and his wife came over and they prophesied over me in my home. And then when that Thanksgiving night came, where I was in a bar in Artesia, New Mexico, this gentleman walked in the door. He had just got out of prison that day, the gentleman that went to jail for trying to pull a gun on me and kill me. He said a few choice words, and I'm 5'7", so I had to get there quick. And I took him to the dance floor, and it knocked him out. And he'd actually died three times on the way to the hospital. Oh. And I heard it over the radio the next morning as we're coming back, and heard that he had died. I went and turned myself in, and when they went and took me for my arraignment, when they said, "All rise," when I stood up, the man that walked out from behind the bench was the first man that ever prophesied over me. Oh.